A very glorious evening to you, people of God. Welcome to our Saturday Love Life service. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you for joining this service. I want you to also share with the broadcast with your friends, share the broadcast with your family and colleagues. Let them know also about this service. It's a very wonderful evening. God is going to speak to us today in a very amazing way. I have no doubt about that. As we discuss about love issues, remember, as I said earlier on, everybody needs love. And love is a blessing from God. All levels of love. It's a blessing from God to find love. As we also delve into relationships and different relationships at different levels, courtship, marriage, and everything that has to do with love. So we are talking about these issues in this particular service. So thank you so much. Let's pray. Father, we thank you. Your name is love. We thank you, Lord, that you have given us love. That, oh God, our families are built out of love. Everything that we see, my God, every meaningful thing is out of love, is made of love. So we thank you, Lord God, for the wisdom. We thank you for the grace. Even as we speak, Lord God, from the word of God, help us to understand your will concerning these matters. In the name of Jesus, I pray for everyone that's going to hear this message, transform them, deliver them, and heal them. Change their lives in a great way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Wonderful. Today we are going to read the word of God from the book of 2 Samuel chapter 13, verses 1 to 15, and then we'll read Genesis 29, 18 to 20. I'm going to read now from verse 1. And it came to pass after this, that Absalom, the son of David, had a fair sister whose name was Tamar, and Amnon, the son of David, loved her. And Amnon was so vexed that he fell sick for his sister Tamar, for she was a virgin. And Amnon thought it hard for him to do anything to her. But Amnon had a friend whose name was Jonadab, the son of Shimei, David's brother. And Jonadab was very subtle man. And he said unto him, Why art thou, being the king's son, lean from day to day? Wilt thou not tell me? And Amnon said, I love Tamar, my sister, Absalom's sister. And Jonadab said unto him, Lay thee down on thy bed, and make thyself sick. And when thy father cometh to see thee, say unto him, I pray thee, let my sister Tamar come and give me meat and dress the meat in my sight, and that I may see it and eat it at her hand. So Amnon lay down and made himself sick. And when the king was come to see him, Amnon said unto the king, I pray thee, let Tamar my sister come and make a couple of cakes in my sight, that I may eat at your hand. Then David sent home to Tamar, saying, Go now to thy brother's house, to thy brother Amnon's house, and dress him neat. So Tamar went to her brother Amnon's house, and he was laid down. And she took flour, kneaded it, and made cakes in his sight, and did bake cakes. And she took a pan and poured them out before him. But he refused to eat, and Amnon said, Have out all men from me. And they went out every man from him. And Amnon said unto Tamar, Bring the meat unto the chamber, and that I may eat out of thine hand. And Tamar took the cakes which she had made, and brought them unto the chamber to Amnon her brother. And when she had brought them unto him to eat, he took hold of her, and said unto her, Come in, lie with me, my sister. And she said unto him, Nay, my brother, do not force me, for such thing ought not to be done in Israel. Do not thou this folly, and I whither shall I cause my shame to go? And as for thee, thou shalt be as one of the fools in Israel. Now therefore I pray thee, speak unto the king, for he will not withhold me from thee. Howbeit he would not hearken unto her voice, but being stronger than he, forced thee and lay with her. Then Amnon hated thee exceedingly, so that the hatred wherewith he hated her was greater than the love wherewith he had loved her. And Amnon said unto her, Arise, be gone. We will leave it there for today. We will leave it there for today. Now we come to the book of Genesis chapter 29. I'm just going to take 18 to 20. And Jacob loved Rachel and said, I will serve thee 7 years for Rachel. thy younger daughter. And Laban said, it is better that I give her to thee than that I should give her to another man. Abide with me. Jacob served 7 years for Rachel, and they seemed unto him but a few days for the love he had to her. God bless the reading of his word this evening. So the title of our message today is Love or Lust. Love or Lust. Now we have an encounter of two examples here that we have read. I'm going to call this the Amnon spirit and the Jacob spirit. Now we are comparing the two and see. Remember, we are talking about love or lust. Let's begin with this example of Amnon. The Bible says this was a son of a king. The man was very sick of love. That's what the Bible says. He felt sick because he loved his sister Tamar. He loved her because she was beautiful, she was fair. And Amnon was so lovesick, and the Bible is using the word vexed. He was vexed in his soul because he supposedly loved this girl. My God. There comes another aspect. But this man had a bad influence of a bad company. He had a bad friend that began to tell him to pretend himself to be sick and have the Tamar to come and give a bread. And you heard what happened. The king authorizing Tamar to go. And then the man began to hold her by force. There is something that the lady said. She said, you know what? Do not do this thing. You are going to be a foolish man. You are going to be one of the foolish people in Israel. Don't do this. And she also said to him, if you really say you love me, why don't you ask the king? The king is still able to give me to you so that I can be your wife. Remember, in the olden days, it was possible even for the people close to marry, to give one another a hand in marriage. So the lady was saying, ask my hand in marriage, and the king is going to do that. And Amnon could not hear that. The Bible says because he was stronger, he forced himself on Tamar and raped her. And soon after they raped her, the Bible says he began to hate her more than he loved her. Oh my Jesus. He began to hate her. So you see how dangerous the Amnon spirit is. This is an advanced spirit that is an advanced spirit of lust that we are seeing here. And I want you to see the manifestation of lust. Lust can only pursue. Lust can only care to as far as it can benefit. Lust can only care as far as it can, to as far as it can get from that relationship. The man was so sick because, look at the language. He felt like he cannot do something on her. He can't do something on the lady. The man was taken by lust. And you see, when lust manifests, when the spirit of lust is at work, it only looks at it, it only considers itself. It only looks at what benefits it. As long as that thing that benefits it is there, as long as it has not gotten that thing that benefits it, the spirit of lust will pursue. But as soon as it gets that thing which it is looking for, then the care ceases. The man began to hate the woman. The man began to hate this lady because the Bible says he hated her more than the love he had for her. That is lust for you. My God, I see many people. You are falling victim of the Amnon spirit. Because this Amnon spirit, as soon as it is done with you, it will reject you. It does not even want to see you. It doesn't want even to be near you. That's the Amnon spirit. There are people that are even possessed by this Amnon spirit. Well, once they violate you, they don't want to see you. You have been a victim of an Amnon spirit, my Jesus. I came to declare today that the Lord remember you today. Let us also look at Jacob. The Bible says Jacob went and he loved Rachel so much. And he said he was talking to his father Laban. And he said, I want this woman. Laban says, it's fine. You can save me for 7 years for this woman. I'm going to give her to you. It's better I give her to you because you are my relative. Jacob, the Bible says, the 7 years were seemed to him as days. They seemed to him as few days. When a love is there, it has got patience. You know, love can wait. Love can go out of its way. The man was willing to serve, and the Bible says 7 years were nothing. They were like few days. Yet Amnon could not wait even for a moment, because the lady says, go and ask your hand in marriage. But he could not hear because of lust. And after that, after he violated it, he hated her more. He hated her more than the love that he had. I don't even think that was love. This was purely advanced level of lust. So many people here, that's why I'm saying, is it love or lust? Many cannot discern. You have fallen victim of an unknown spirit. Right now, you are going through a lot of rejection. You are going through a lot of rejection. Like, there's a lot that is happening. Failure, relationships are failing because you are falling victim of unknown spirit. It is a spirit that cares to as far as what it can get. It is a spirit that says, I will pursue with all my strength. Once I get what I can get, I will reject you. I'm talking to somebody here. I'm talking to somebody. Look how this man was so pretending to be sick. There are people that will pretend to care to as far as they can just get what they want. The moment they get what they want, they will run away from you. They will dump you. They will reject you. That is the unknown spirit that we are talking about. My God, my God. And many have fallen victim of the unknown spirit. Love or lust. It takes the grace of God to discern. You need to discern to understand, what am I dealing with? Is this the Jacob that I'm praying? I pray that God will send a Jacob to you. 7 years were nothing to him. 7 years were just days, because he had genuine love for this woman. You know even what happened. There was a switch. He was shortchanged, and he was given Leah. Instead of being given Rachel, he loved. He had to wait again 14 more years because he loved this woman. There was genuine love that is able to pursue, genuine love that is able to wait. It is able to wait. There is patience with love. There is patience with love. Look at how this man could not wait. The lady was very open. She said, if you really love me, you can go to the king. You can even ask the king for me and say, can I have, the king is not going to withhold you from me. Amnon could not wait, because when lust manifests, it says, I want it now. When lust manifests, it says, I can't wait a moment. When lust manifests, it says, I can't wait any longer. That is the spirit of Amnon. I see many girls, I see many people. You have been victims of the Amnon spirit. You have been used and dumped. You have been left hate, because the Bible says he hated her more than the love that he had for her. When lust is satisfied, it ceases, because that's only as far as it can go. Lust cannot go beyond to what it can get. If lust is fulfilled, that is all. There is no more caring. My God, is it love or lust? You need to understand. You need to discern. Many people now, they are falling victims of this kind of spirit. That's why I came to give you words of wisdom, that when you pray, you must pray. How do you pray? Even as I'm speaking to those that are aspiring, you are praying for marriage. How do you pray? Pray and say, God, deliver me from the unknown spirit. Deliver me from the unknown spirit. What is the unknown spirit? Those are the people that can only care for you to as far as they can defy you, to as far as they can have what they can have from you. As long as they, after having you, they won't even care about you. Amnon's hatred was too much. There was no more love. There was no more love. It was not love from the beginning. It was just if the spirit, advanced spirit of lust. I need you to understand this. You are really crying and saying things are not working. No, no, no. The thing is, you are not discerning. You can't discern whether it's the Amnon spirit or it's the Jacob spirit. If you can't discern, you will always be disappointed. When you pray, you must pray, God, deliver me from the Amnon spirit. I want you to send a Jacob in my life. I want you to send a Jacob is going to work 14 years for you. A Jacob is going to wait. A Jacob is going to go even to do anything to help you. He is going to wait. But this man could not wait anymore. And after being given what he was sick for, He began to hate it more than the love he had for. That is an Amnon spirit for you. Love or lust? That's the question I have for you. Love or lust? This is what you need to pray for. This is the discernment that you need. Oh my God. Love or lust? Look at the events. Look at the chain of events that begin to go here. Look at the chain of events. Lust is very dangerous because the moment it is satisfied, everything stops there. It can't go beyond what it wants to get. It can't go beyond what it can get. That's as far as it can go. That's as far as it can care. It cares to the level where it can get something. As long as it cannot get something from there, it cannot care. It stops to care. That is the Amnon spirit. My God. My God, today I just came to give counsel. Is it love or lust? You are in a relationship. Before you commit, before you really commit, is it love or lust? This takes the Holy Spirit. Because look, even the Bible is using the word love. The Bible is using the word love here. But you need to understand that this is not love. This is lust. Is it love or lust? It takes the discerning of the Spirit. It takes you to discern. Is it the unknown spirit? The unknown spirit that fell sick, he was sick for love. He was love sick for this girl. When the girl came, after having the girl, he started to hate her. He started to hate her with too much hatred, more than the lust that he had for her. My God, but I pray that God will bring in your path that Jacob, that will work, and the days will be shorter. 7 years will be like few days. The Bible says 7 years. There were like few days. Jacob had love. Love can endure. Love can do anything. It can pursue. It can even go beyond because of the love that he had for her. My God, can I pray for a young lady? Can I pray for someone? I pray for you that God deliver you from the Amnon spirit. You are in a courtship. God deliver you from the Amnon spirit. God remove from your path the Amnon spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. You have been meeting people with an Amnon spirit. You have been rejected. You are suffering right now. You are so broken. I pray for you. Be delivered from the Amnon spirit. Receive your Jacob. Let a Jacob come your way. Who is the Jacob? Someone that can wait that longer. Someone that can wait that longer just to help you. That's a Jacob. These are people that are marriage material. I pray for you. Let a Jacob come your way. Let a Jacob come your way. In the name of Jesus Christ, may God deliver you from the unknown spirit. In the mighty, mighty name of Jesus Christ, I thank you. These are the little words of counsel that I had for you this evening. The Lord God bless you. I'm with you again tomorrow at 11 a.m. Spread this word. Share this message to your friends. They need to hear this message. It will help them. The Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. We are meeting again for our Sunday general service tomorrow at 11 a.m. I will see you again. Your servant in the Lord, Lloyd Gangata. Shalom.